Hello students, welcome back to the session. So we have just discussed about police inquest. So we will talk about magistrate inquest after that. So the magistrate inquest is something which is defined under the CRPC 176 and it is conducted by a magistrate who is a deputy magistrate or a sub-deputy magistrate or a tehsildar or could be any other magistrate who is empowered by the state government, could be an executive magistrate. So they would be conducting the inquest. An inquest is a formal procedure. It is a investigation into a case where there is suspicious or unnatural death. What are the conditions which necessitate magistrate inquest? Now, if there is a death which takes place in police custody, that would be a condition for magistrate inquest. If there is death due to police firing which is involved, death of a convict in prison. Who's a convict? A convict is somebody who's accused of conducting a crime and they would be held in police custody till there's a trial which is mandated in a court of law, and once it is proven that they are either guilty or innocent, based on that they would be either acquitted or released, or they would have to serve their punishment. If there's a death of a convict in prison, it becomes government's responsibility to handle their life. Okay, and death in psychiatric ward or hospital. Dowry death, that is death within 7 years of marriage. Now dowry deaths are actually coming down, it's declining. Exhumation. What is an exhumation? An exhumation is an order which is given to uncover the bodies which were buried under the ground. So basically exhumation is the Latin word for out of the ground. So in certain cases exhumation would be necessary because we would need evidence and we would need certain details which would be useful to solve a particular case. So exhumation, now that can be ordered by a magistrate or a coroner, which we will be looking into in the next few slides. Any person who dies or disappears or is raped is alleged to have been committed. If rape is alleged to have been committed on any woman who is in the custody of the police, then that would mandate a magistrate inquest, and in these cases the magistrate would definitely have to conduct the inquest in addition to that of the police inquest. Now, after we learn what is police inquest and magistrate inquest, we need to know a coroner's inquest. Now, this is something which is conducted in US and in other countries, and it is not actually prevalent in India. It was, however, prevalent in India during the British period, but currently it is not conducted in India. Now, a coroner is somebody who conducts an investigation in all cases where there is suspected unnatural death. So a coroner is somebody who's appointed by the government. He's a government official who would have to foresee all the events which take place under the investigation of a case of suspected unnatural death. He would have to investigate the death of convicts in jail, deaths of people who are in police custody, deaths of patients in mental hospitals, etc. Now what we discussed in the previous slide, all those functions would also be conducted by a coroner. A coroner's court is a court of inquiry but not trial. So they don't have judicial powers as such, but they are empowered to summon witnesses and they can record their evidence on oath. And they can also conduct post-mortem examination. They can call upon doctors to give their opinion and can also order exhumation, that is digging up of the bodies which were buried previously. So those kind of they have the power to order exhumation as well. So that is about the coroner's inquest. Now the difference between police inquest and coroner's inquest is such that the coroner's inquest is superior to that of police inquest, and the coroner can summon witnesses, the coroner can issue a warrant of arrest. What is a warrant? A warrant is a written order which mandates the arrest of a particular person because they are accused of committing a crime. The coroner can also summon the doctor to give their evidence in court, can order exhumation, and can also order for the conduction of a autopsy when there is foul play involved, when we want to know the cause of death. Okay, so what is the medical examiner system? The medical examiner system is the most superior form of inquest which we studied till now. It is conducted in the US and it is conducted by a medical examiner who is a forensic pathologist. Now this is the reason why it is the most superior form of inquest, because the qualification which is necessary is that they are a forensic pathologist. So they would have the complete knowledge of the subject. So they would be fluent and their skills would be necessary in order to conduct the investigation, and they have no judicial functions like that of a coroner. However, it is superior to police and coroner's inquest, because the forensic pathologist is somebody who has a lot of scientific knowledge, medical and legal knowledge as well. Now, there are different courts of law, and there are basically two types of courts. We have the civil court and the criminal court, just like we have civil law and criminal law. Now, when we talk about criminal courts, we have four types. We have the Supreme Court, we have the High Court, we have the Sessions Court and the Magistrate Court. Now, the Supreme Court is the highest judicial office in the country. Then we have the High Court in the states, and we have Sessions Court in different areas. Just like that, we have the Chief Judicial Magistrate or the Chief Metropolitan Magistrate, depends on the place. Judicial Magistrate, first class and second class. So this is the hierarchy of the courts and the hierarchy of the people who hold the office in these areas. So, based on the power of magistrate, which is given by the section 29 of the CRPC or the Criminal Procedure Code, we have the class of magistrate and their power to issue an imprisonment or issue a fine in cases. So, the chief judicial magistrate can order imprisonment of somebody who is guilty of a crime for up to 7 years with unlimited fine. The first class judicial magistrate can order imprisonment up to 3 years with a fine of ₹10,000, and the second class judicial magistrate can order an imprisonment up to 1 year with a fine of ₹5,000. As you can see, there is a hierarchy, there is a power which is deemed, which is held by these people, namely the judicial magistrate and the first class and the second class judicial magistrate. So that is the power of the magistrates based on, which is given by the CRPC. Now, there are types of law. As I've told you, there is a civil law, there is a criminal law. Now, the difference between civil law and criminal law is, civil law is something which concerns private rights. So, we're just talking about people and their or a group of people, and the criminal law is something which violates something which is written down in IPC itself. And in civil law, we're talking about a simple case where it could be related to property, it could be related to certain other affairs of the person involved. But in criminal law, we're talking about punishment which could go up to imprisonment or fine or both. Right, and in civil law, there is a preponderance of evidence. So evidence would be the first and foremost thing which is necessary. And in criminal law, it would have to be proven beyond a reasonable doubt that the person is guilty of committing a crime. Only then would punishment be deemed necessary in that case. So examples where civil law would be necessary would be like divorce cases and lawsuits. And criminal laws, we are talking about traffic violation, felony charges. So felony is basically, we're talking about murder, or it could be related to theft, burglary, and those sort of charges. So yeah, that is the difference between civil law and criminal law.